Good morning, children. I am Salmas here. Hope you all are fine. We already started our 15th lesson, Light. We did the part 1 video last class and we have spoken about few things. I hope you all remember this. So today we are going to study the second part of our lesson, Light. Okay, last class we were discussing about the clay mirrors and I told you what is an image, what is an object, and the image formed on the mirror cannot be taken on a screen. So all those things we discussed last class. And one more thing, it is the right or left. So you know that when you are looking into the plain mirror, you are lifting your right hand, but the mirror, what do you see? You see that the image in the mirror, the left hand will be, if you are raising the right hand in the mirror, you will see your left hand. So that is the only difference between the object and the image formed on the plane mirror. It is the opposite sides. That's all it is. Otherwise, it is the same. You will find that in the mirror it appears right will be your left. Okay, now you can see. Okay, now just write your name in a piece of paper and hold it in front of the mirror and just see what you will can see in that. You can see your name written upside down, right? So only the difference in the image formed in the plane mirror is, it is the inverted. You cannot see it straight. The writing is inverted. But otherwise, yourself means if you raise your left hand, you can see your right hand in the image in the mirror. Okay, that is the only difference. And now you have seen ambulance written upside down on the van, on the ambulance. You must have seen ambulance is written upside down. Why it is so means, when the person in front of the ambulance, when he is looking through the mirror, he can read it as ambulance. So that is why it is written upside down, so that everybody can give way for the ambulance. So that is about the plane mirror. It is only, plane mirror is only it appears left, right appears left, and the left appears right. That's the only change you see between the object and the image of the plane mirror. Okay, next, playing with spherical mirrors. Playing with spherical mirrors. So what is this spherical mirror? So what is this spherical mirrors? You have two types of spherical mirrors. That is, one is concave and other one is, you have two mirrors. One is the concave mirror and other one is the convex mirror. So we will see what it is. Now, when you take a spoon like this, you have two, you can see your face on the spoon, right? But the images you see on the spoon is different. When you keep, you put the spoon far away from you, you can see a inverted image on the spoon. Same like that, when you put it the other way, you can see the image. You can see the image on the steel spoon because this acts as a mirror. But you have two types, two sides for this spoon. Okay, you can see this. You have one portion bulged outside and you can see another portion which is deep inside like this. Okay, now what is this deep inside? So this deep inside is, so you have, now this is the two plane mirrors. See, this is the, you can see the two surfaces on the spoon. One is bulged outside and one is curved inside. Okay, now this plain one, this is the reflecting surface. Now this is the not reflecting surface. So now this part which you see inside, which is curved. Now this is the reflecting surface. This is the rough surface. This is the reflecting surface where you can see your face. So this is the inside. This is the curved portion. So this curved portion is called the concave. This curved portion is called the concave side. And this bulged portion which you see outside is the convex. So this is the reflecting surface. This is the non-reflecting surface. So this side, this is called the convex mirror. Since you can see the face on the spoon, this is the shiny metal spoon, steel spoon, where you can see your face on it. It acts as a mirror. Now, there are two surfaces for this spoon. One is curved inside. So this curved portion is called the concave portion. This curved portion is called the concave portion, and this bulged outside portion is called the convex portion. So both the you can see your face on both the sides, but it is different. When you see in the concave mirror, what happens? You can see this concave. This is the concave portion. You can see yourself inverted in this. But when you turn the spoon on the convex side, you can see your erect image. So now we will see about the concave mirrors. So we will see little bit in detail how will be the image formed by the concave mirror. Now, why it is called spherical mirrors? That is because now you can take a ball, you know, round ball, cut the ball into two pieces. So how is it? You can see one outer portion and one inside portion. So concave means it is this portion. Concave. So imagine now this is a ball, portion of a ball. So this is concave portion. This is concave. That means it is deep like this inside. So this outer portion is bulged and this is called the convex. So this is why we call it spherical mirrors. These are the portion of the spherical ball like shape. Okay, now page number 180, we are going to read the activity 15.6. Here you take a concave mirror like this and hold it facing the sun and put a piece of paper down so you can bring the image of the sun on the paper. A bright white spot can be brought on the paper. Take a concave mirror. See some mirror like this, which is you have a deep surface like this, and put it outside and put a paper down. So that paper is going to act as a screen. Now using this mirror, you can bring that spot of the sun on the paper. You can see that bright spot will make the paper burn after some time. So this is the image of the sun. You have brought it and okay, take a concave mirror, hold it facing the sun. Try to get the light reflected by the mirror on a sheet of paper. Adjust the distance of the paper until you get it sharp, bright spot on it. Hold the mirror and sheet of paper steady for few minutes. Does the paper start burning? After some time, you can see the paper burning. This bright spot is nothing but the image of the sun. So, this image is formed on the screen. So, I told you the paper is the screen. So, an image formed on the screen is called the real image. Okay. So, last class I told you what is the image. It is the image, it is the what? Image means, I have told you, what you see on the mirror is called the image. Now, you can bring this image using the concave mirror on a sheet of paper. That sheet of paper is the screen. So, we now using the concave mirror, you have brought the image of the sun on the screen. So, that type of images are called the real images. So, those type of images are called real images. It is called real image. We have brought the image of the sun on a sheet of paper, and the paper acts as a screen. So, we have brought the image on the screen. So, those type of images are called the real image. Now, I told you, plane mirrors, you cannot bring the image on the screen. So, that those type of images are called the virtual image. Those type of images are called the virtual image. Okay. Now, the experiment, activity 15.7. You have taken the concave mirror. You have put an object in the middle. Then you have a screen. Now, you have to adjust this candle so that the flame will be seen on this mirror. It will be seen on this screen. You should obtain the image of this on the screen. So, this is a mirror object and this is the paper. That is the screen. Now, keep a lighted candle on the table at a distance of about 50 centimeter. Try to obtain the image of the flame on the screen. For this, move the screen till a sharp image of the flame is obtained. So, the screen should be adjusted so that the image of this is obtained on the screen. The screen does not. So, now, in this, is this real or virtual? Is this same size as the flame? Now, move the candle towards the mirror and place it at different distances from it. In each case, you can change the screen. You can change the screen and you can obtain the mirror on. You can obtain the image on the screen. And also, you can move the candle close to the mirror and adjust so that how it is falling on the screen. So, now move the candle towards the mirror and place it at different distances from it. In each case, try to obtain the image on the screen. Record your observations. Is it possible to obtain the image on the screen when the candle is too close to the mirror? We see that the image formed by a concave mirror can be smaller or larger than the object. So, when you place it close and all those things, you can see different type of images on it. It can be smaller or larger image than the flame. This is the object. So, the image formed on the screen may be smaller or larger. It can be real or virtual. So, the image formed by the concave mirror is smaller or larger than the object, or real or virtual. The image may be real or virtual. You can bring it on the screen. It can be taken on the screen. That is the real image. Sometimes it cannot be taken on the screen. So, that is the virtual. Depending on the position of the candle. If you place it too close or too far away from it. So, that is the concave mirror. Now, these concave mirrors, where all they are used? These are used for many purposes. Mostly, doctors are using the concave mirrors for examining eyes, ears, nose and throat. Concave mirrors are also used by the dentists to see the enlarged image of the teeth. So this concave mirrors are used by the doctors, dentist, to see your teeth bigger. Then the reflectors of torches, headlights of cars and scooters are concave in shape. So these are the places where the concave mirrors are used. Okay, children. So I hope you understood this much. We have discussed only about the concave mirror today. I have told you concave mirror means it is a part of spherical mirror. When you cut a ball into two pieces, you will get a cave. What you see inside, the curved portion, is called the concave mirror. Understood? Now, I told you about the real and virtual images. Real image means it can be the image can be brought on a screen. So that is the real image. Virtual image means you cannot bring the image on a screen. That is the virtual image. So the concave mirror is used when you do this experiment. You can adjust all this to see. You can do this activity at home and prior. So you can see that the image formed by the concave mirror is smaller or larger than the object, and the image is real or virtual. That is, it can be brought on the screen when the candle is placed at different length. Sometimes you will not be brought on the screen. So it is virtual. So that is about this convex mirror. We will discuss in the next video. So I hope you understood this much. Read your text. Have a nice day. Thank you.